trying to clear my head. I don't know where you are. Guessing time and in my mind, yeah, thinking that you are gone. I remember when you told me I was your only one, but you'll be.
How do you manage it all?
I just try not to think about it. It's fun for me. You know, this is something that I have a passion for, and I work hard for everything that I do, but I don't think of it as working hard. It's just fun.
So you work it out because it's enjoyable.
Yeah, I enjoy every single thing that I do. If I didn't, then I wouldn't be doing it.
Right. So, it's Sam Bilal, and then you have Sam Bilal and the Danville. They are two totally different entities, right?
Correct.
You have the rock band. And how do you manage the rock band and then your solo project?
Like you said, they're two different projects. With the Danvilles, it's mostly like a rock alternative, whereas the Sam Bilal is just more so innovative with R&B, pop, alternative, so it's a little bit of everything, whereas the Danvilles, it's just, you know, that one thing. And with myself, I can kind of branch out and do other things, you know.
Yeah. So how did the Danvilles come about?
Well, Mike, who is the founder of the Danvilles and also Merrifield Records, I met him, it's a great story, but I met him through someone else, who thought I was just a model, and I'm like, no, I'm a singer, actually. And they're like, okay, well, my brother knows somebody that does such and such. So, long story short, I met Mike, and about a couple of months ago, we started rehearsing, and then I met the other members of the band. So, it's Mike, who plays the guitar, Kenny, who plays the bass, and then Dex, who plays the drums. And we just came together, and the next day, we're like, okay, we have a show. And then after that, we just start performing every day, so.
So, the other side is Sam Bilal by herself, that is Eclectic Soul.
Yeah.
Tell us more about your sound.
Yeah, well, it's always evolving, so now it's more so pop, and my album, Big Red Box, that's coming out, you'll see exactly what I mean. So, it's more so something that I've been doing since I was a little girl. I started out singing with my dad, and I have four younger siblings, so we started singing together, and we were like the mini Jackson 5, and because my parents are from Gary, Indiana, it kind of stuck with us, and I just kind of branched out and did my own thing.
So speaking of your father, he's military, and so you guys moved around a lot when you were younger.
Yeah.
California, and then Asia, and any places in between?
Yeah, well, mostly there. I was born in Moreno Valley, California. And we moved to Turkey when I was 3. So my other brother, AP, is a producer who does a lot of work in the area as well, was born in Turkey. We moved back to the States. And we actually didn't move around as much as a lot of military brats do. But we did move around when I was younger. And then we settled in D.C. and I love it. So,
so how did those experiences influence your music, or do they?
They do. I think it makes me more well-rounded as a person and open-minded. So when I hear different sounds or when I see different artists, I'm like, oh, that's cool. That's different, whereas a lot of people are like, I don't know about that. But it definitely helps me out as an artist and as a person as a whole.
Now, going back also into your history, you went to Duke Ellington, and you got accepted into Berklee School of Music, but you didn't pursue that. Why not?
Berklee is a great school. It's just so expensive. It's like you have to really want to do that. To me, school is an option. You know, if you feel as if you can do it, achieve your goals another way, or take another path, then I don't feel like it's necessary. If you have the money and that's what you want to do, then by all means, go ahead. But modeling is just something that I did to further my career in the music industry. So, of course, you know, with press kit, you need pictures, and then you meet people, and people are like, oh, okay, well, can you, you know, wear my designs, or can you rock my jewelry? I have this ring. Alma Mayer made this, actually. It's really, really cool. It has, like, the lotion, the perfume, and everything.
Yeah. And she's local?
She's actually in, I believe, in Chicago. But yeah, she's really dope. But, you know, that's another thing. So people ask me where their designs and their jewelry, and I'm just like, hey, cool. And then I meet other people, and I'm like, okay, you know, just go from there. So, yeah, it's fun.
Yeah.
I guess I like taking pictures.
Yeah. Nothing wrong with that.
Yeah.
So you released a single last year, Beautiful Loser.
Yeah.
What was the message behind that song?
Beautiful Loser is actually written by AD, the producer, and I heard the song in our studio, and he left out, and I was like, I'm taking that song, like, that has to be the song. So, the message behind it is basically, no matter what you do, when you fail, you can always manage to get back up. And I told him, I said, this is my song, stay over here, okay? I told him, I'm doing a video for it, and he can't say anything to me, because I feel like, you know, a lot of people can relate to this message, and I don't want the song to sit. You know, I think that people have a right to hear a powerful, more, a motivational speech in a song.
So it also resonated with you, you could relate to it?
Definitely. Definitely. Especially in the industry, you're always going to hear no. No matter what, you always have to manage to get back up.
And so you executive produced it, and you were the creative director.
Yes.
So what made you take hands-on control? I mean, you weren't just in front of the camera, you were behind it.
Yeah, I like doing that. I like to be hands-on. That way, my ideas can be executed, and I'm happy at the end. And a lot of work and money goes into projects like that, so it's good to be hands-on where people understand. And, you know, in the future, if I want to just sit back, I'll know how to do it because I've done it in the past.
So tell us about this cartoon. You're doing a voiceover for a character.
Yeah, the creator actually doesn't want me to say who I'm playing because he wants this to be a mystery, but yes, the cartoon is Yo-Yo DC, and it's based in DC, so all of the characters, they're different artists. We have Raw the MC, K-Beta, Action Jackson, who's actually the creator of it, so they're different characters, and it's like a Boondocks meets, like, anime. It's really cool, like, different, it's fun, it's exciting to play another role.
Yeah. So you have a new album coming out. It's called
The Big Rip Off. It'll be released on February 22nd, 2011. My first single will drop December 31st, 2010. So I'm really excited about that. And you can go on to sambalowmusic.com and see all of the updates. I can't tell you the name of it yet.
Okay.
But you have to check it out, and then we'll put out the promotional songs before that as well.
So in the meantime, where can we see you performing?
Oh, well, my next show is in New York with my rock band, The Danvilles. And all of my dates are on my website as well. So just check out sambalowmusic.com. But I have a lot of dates in December. So.
Well, we'll definitely look out for the album and stay on the website for the show. But it's been a pleasure talking with you.
Thank you so much.
Good luck with everything.
Everybody, this is Isambola. I want to give a huge, big, gigantic shout out to Jukebox DC. When you keep on.